Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss exercise 7.1 from question number 11. First part is increase the number 60 by 30%. This question we are doing with a shortcut method. When we are talking about percentage, it means we are talking about 100. So here 30% means for 100 rupees we have to increase 30 rupees. So suppose I have taken, if original number is 100, then after 30% increased it will become 130. So but according to the question, original number is here 60. So after 30% increase, suppose it will become x. After that we have to do the cross because it is a direct variation. Then 100 into x is equal to 60 into 130. Next step, this 100 you can shift another side, it will go for division. Do the cancellation, both the zeros will cancel out. Multiply 13 and 6, you will get answer. X value is 78. So after the increment, number will become 78. Second part, decrease the number 750 by 10%. So this question also we are doing with same method. Suppose the original number is 100 and after decreasing 10%, it will become 90. 10% of 100 will be 10. So after decrease 10%, it will become 90. But according to the question, original number is 750. So let after decreasement, it will become x. Cross it. 100 and x will come together. 750 and 90 will come together. Next step, this 100 shift another side. Do the cancellation, both the zeros will cancel out. 75 into 9, 675. So decreased number will be 675. Question number 12. What number when increased by 50% become 299? In this question, we have to find out the original number and increased number is given here. So read question carefully. What is given, you have to find out. So suppose original number is 100, so after increasing 15%, it will become 115. Now we have to find out the original number and after increment, it become 299. Placing this value at correct place is very very important for these type of questions. So 299 is here, increased number, it will come here. After that, do the cross multiply, x and 115 will come one side. 100 and 299 will come another side. Next step, 115, you can shift another side, it will go for division. Do the cancellation. I have cancelled here with 5 table, 520 and 523. Then after 23, 13 times. So answer will be 260. So original number is here 260. Second part, on decreasing a number by 18%, it becomes 697. Find the number. So suppose original number is 100, after 18% decreasing it will become 82. 100 minus 18, 82. Original number, suppose it is x and after decreasing it becomes 697. Cross multiply, 82x is equal to 100 into 697. 82, shift another side, do the cancellation. First I have cancelled with 2 table, 250 and 241, then 41, 17 times. 50 into 17, 850. It means original number was 850. Question number 13. Mr. Khanna spent 83% of his salary and saved rupees 1870. Calculate his monthly salary. So suppose his monthly salary is here x rupees. He is spending 83%, so he is saving 17%. If we are talking about percentage, 83% he spent, so saving will be 100 minus 83, 17%. And numerically the saving is 1870 rupees. So it means 17% of total salary will be equal to this. So 17% of x will be 1870 rupees. Next, percentage symbol means by 100, of means multiplication, x is equal to this. Next step, 17 by 100, shift another side, it will become 100 by 17. And then you can do the cancellation and multiply. You will get x value is 11,000. So Mr. Khanna's salary is 11,000 rupees. Question number 14. In a school, 38% of the students are girl, and if the number of boys is 1023 rupees, find the total strength of the school. So suppose the total strength of the school is X, and girls is given 38%. It means boys will be 100 minus 38, 62%. But the number of boys is given 1023. It means the 62% of total strength will be equal to 1023. So 62% of X is equal to 1023. 62 by 100. Percent means by 100. Of means multiplication X. Next step, 62 by 100. Shift another side. It will become 100 by 62. Do the cancellation. First I have cancelled with 2 table and then with 31 table. So X value will be 1650. It means the total strength of a school is 1650 students. Question number 15. The price of an article increased from 960 rupees to 1080 rupees. Find the increase percentage. This question also we are doing with shortcut method. So first original price was 960 rupees and after increasing it become 1080 rupees. We are calculating now according to the 100. Suppose original price is 100 and after increasing it become X. Then cross multiply 960 into X is equal to 1080 into 100. Next step, 960 shift another side and do the cancellation. X value you will get 112.5. So before we have taken price, original price is 100 rupees and after increasing it become 112 rupees 50 paise. So for 100 rupees how much it is increasing? It is increasing 12.5 and same percentage will come because we are calculating according to 100, so no need to calculate percentage again. The difference between these two number will be the percentage. So 12.5%. Question number 16. In a straight contest, the loser polled 42% vote and lost by 14,400 votes. Find the total number of vote polled. If the total number of eligible voters was 1 lakh, find what percentage of voter did not vote. In this question, it has given here total voters are 1 lakh, but whole 1 lakh has not polled. Few has polled. So let the number of voter polled is X here. And loser got 42%, it means winner got 100 minus 42, 58%. And numerically, the winner polled minus loser polled is 14,400 votes. The difference between winner and loser is 14,400. And if we calculate according to our calculation, the difference between winner and loser will be 58 minus 42, 16% of total vote. The difference is coming here 16. So 16% of total votes will be equal to given value in question. Remove the percentage symbol by 100. Next step, shift it another side. X value will be 14,400 into 100 by 16. Do the cancellation. X value will be 90,000. It means 90,000 voters has polled, but total eligible voters are 1 lakh. So how many voters have not polled? 10,000 voters has not polled here. So we'll calculate percentage for that. 10,000 voters did not polled. Total was 1 lakh. So 10,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100%. To convert into percentage, multiply with 100%. Cancel zeros. 4 zeros will cancel out here. 1 zero will cancel out here. And you will get answer 10%. Question number 17. Out of 8,000 candidates, 60% were boys and 80% of boys and 90% of girls passed the exam. Find the number of candidates whose failed. Here they have given total candidates are 8,000 and boys are 60%. So number of boys will be 60% of 8,000. 60% means by 100 into 8,000. Zeros we can cancel. And then 4,800. Number of boys are 4,800. And the number of girls will be total minus boys. So 3,200. Now, according to the question, number of boys who passed exam, 80% boys passed the exam. So, 80% of boys, 4,800. Calculate 3,840. And the number of girls who passed the exam, 90% is given. So, 90% of girls, 3,200. So, 2,880 girls passed the exam. If we calculate according to the total, so total pass exam, boys plus girls, 3,840 plus 2,880. It means 6,720 candidate passed the exam. Next, number of students who failed. Total students are 8,000 and from that 6,720 passed the exam. Take the difference. It means 1,280 students failed in this exam. Question number 18. On increasing the price of an article by 16%, it becomes 1,479. What was its original price? So, let original price if 100, then after increasing 16%, it will become 116. For this question, let the original price is X and after increasing, it has become 1,479. Cross multiply. 116x is equal to 1479 into 100. 100 shift in 16 shift another side. Do the cancellation. So we will get original price was 1275 rupees. Question number 19. Pratibha reduced her weight by 15%. If now she weighed 59.5 kg, what was her earlier weight? So, suppose her earlier weight was 100 and she reduced 15%. So, reduced weight will be 100 minus 15, 85. And let her earlier weight was X. So, after reducing, it become 59.5. After reducing, her weight is 59.5. Cross multiply it, 85X is equal to 100 into 59.5. 85 shift another side, do the cancellation. Then you will get X value. It means her earlier weight was 70 kg. Question number 20. In a sale, a shop reduces all its price by 15%. First part, calculate the cost of an article which was originally priced as 40 rupees. So first part, original price and reduced price. Suppose original price is 100. So after reducing 15%, it will become 100 minus 15, 85. And in this question, original price is given 40 rupees. After reducing, it becomes suppose X. Cross multiply it, 100X is equal to 40 into 85. Shift 100 another side, do the cancellation. So reduced price will be 34 rupees. Second part, the original price of an article which was sold for 20 rupees 40 paise. This is same question only, second part. So suppose original price was 100, after 15% reduction it become 85. Original price suppose it is X, so after reducing it has become 20 rupees 40 paise. Do the cross multiply, 85X is equal to 100 into 20 rupees 40 paise. Shift 85 another side and do the cancellation, X value you will get 24 rupees. So it means original price was 24 rupees. Question number 21. Increase the price of rupees 200 by 10% and then decrease the new price by 10%. Is the final price same as the original price? In this question, first we have to increase the price and then we have to decrease the price. So first, suppose original price is 100 rupees, after increasing 10%, it will become 110. And according to the question, original price is 200. So after increasing, it become X. Cross multiply, 100X is equal to 200 into 110. Shift X another side, do the cancellation. X value is 220. It means after increasing, it has become 220. Now next we have to decrease it by 10%. So suppose original is 100 and after decreasing 10%, it become 100 minus 10, 90. And here increase price is 220 and after decreasing suppose it has become X. Cross multiply it, 100X is equal to 90 into 220. So x value will be 19 to 220 by 100. Cancel both the zeros and 198. It means final price is 198. Now you can see whether both are equal or not. No, final price is not equal to original price. Original price was 200 and our final we are getting 198. Question number 22. Chandini purchased some parrots. 20% flew away and 5% died. Of the remaining 45% were sold. Now 33 parrots remain. How many parrots had Chandini purchased? So suppose she has purchased X parrots. From that 20% has flew away, 5% died. It means now remaining is 75%. Minus 20, minus 5. So remaining she is having 75%. So number of parrots remaining, 75% of X means 75 by 100 into X. After cancellation, 3 by 4X. Now from these parrots also, 45% she has sold out. So remaining will be 55%. So remaining parrots will be 55% of 3 by 4x. 55 by 100 into 3 by 4 will get 165 by 400x. But according to the question, remaining parrots are 33. And according to our calculation, 165x by 400 is remaining parrots. So both the values we can equate. 165x by 400 is equal to 33. Shift this value another side. 33 into 400 by 165. Do the cancellation. X value is 80. It means she purchased 80 parrots. Question number 23. A candidate who got 36% marks in an exam failed by 24 marks. And another candidate who gets 43% marks get 18% more marks than minimum passing marks. Find the maximum marks and the percentage of passing marks. Suppose the maximum marks are X. Now first person passing marks will be equal to second person passing marks because passing marks will be same for both. First person is getting 36% of X. But he failed by 24 marks. So we are giving this first person 24 marks. So he will come to the passing border. Now second person 43% he got 43% of X and he is getting 18 more. So that 18 we are taking from this. So now both are on passing stage. So 36% of X plus 24 he will pass and 43% of X minus 18 then he will pass. Both will come at the same percentage. Remove the percentage 36 by 100X plus 24. 43 by 100x minus 18. Now the x shift one side and number shift another side. So 36x by 100 minus 43x by 100 is equal to minus 18 and minus 24. Minus 18 minus 24 will become minus 42 and here 36 minus 43 will become minus 7x. Both the side minus you can cancel out. Shift 7 by 100 another side it will become 100 by 7. Do the cancellation. Then maximum marks you will get 600. Next we have to find out the passing marks. So any one we can take for first candidate or second candidate. Both are same. So any one we will take. So 36% of 600 plus 24. 36% of 600 is 216. Plus 24, so passing marks are 240 marks. We will calculate the passing percentage. He is getting 240 marks out of 600. To convert into percentage, multiply with 100%. So passing percentage is 40%. Question number 24. The sides of a rectangle are 20 cm and 15 cm. If each side is increased by 20%, find the percentage increase in the area. So first condition is given length is 20 cm, breadth is 15 cm. So area will be length into breadth 20 into 15, 300. Now second condition, if both the length and breadth has increased by 20%. So length will become 20 plus 20% of 20. Calculate it 4, so 24. And breadth will become 15 plus 20% of 15. 15 plus 3, 18. So increased area will be 24 into 18. 24 into 18, 432. Now you can see the difference. First it was 300 and then it become 432. So increase in area will be 432 minus 300, 132. We have to find out the increase percentage. Now increase in area is 132. Original was 300. Then multiply by 100%. Do the cancellation. So increase in percentage is 44%. Question number 25. Imran gives 1% of his monthly income to his son as pocket money. The elder son gets 80% of the total amount given and he spent 80% of his share. If he saves 60 rupees per month, determine Imran's monthly salary. So suppose Imran is getting X rupees per month and two sons he is giving 1% of X. So 1% of X will be X by 100. Now elder son is getting 80% of this money. So 80% of X by 100 is equal to 4X by 500. Then this elder son, he is spending 80%. It means he is saving 20%. So his saving is 20% of this amount, 4X by 500. So 20% of 4X by 500 is equal to 4X by 2500. And according to the question, his saving is 60 rupees. So we can equate these two values. 4x by 2500 is equal to 60 rupees. So x will be 60 into 2500 by 4. Do the cancellation. X value will be 37,500. It means his monthly salary is 37,500 rupees. Thank you for watching our video.